All right, we're back with Ronnie with part five, getting started. Ronnie's brand new, just getting started, and we're just going over the whole process. And today's training, we're gonna go over just putting everything together with Deal Machine, with the CRM. We're gonna be looking at live leads, live deals, and then we're gonna be going over how we analyze them, how we come up with the offers. So we're gonna get into that right now. We have live deals to look at, so let's take a look at these deals and let's show you how we're coming up with these offers. Okay. So I have students that send me deals. For example, so Andre Hill sent me a deal. So if you are a new student, you need the handholding, this is what you can do, right? Like you get someone, an owner that says, "I want an offer." They raise their hand. You put the lead in the CRM. So you basically just fill out the CRM and you just send us the name of the lead. You can send us the link with the address or the name of the seller. And then we'll just, so our member just sent us the name of the lead and the address. So you see that. Hey, this leads in the CRM. Let me know the offer. Two bedrooms. So I'm gonna go into that lead that was entered, and then we're gonna go in and come up with these offers. Okay. So here's the lead here, Jennifer Talley. We have the address. He put the square footage in. It looks like there's no basement. So to come up with the offers, again, square feet, it's got to be in there, the condition. So he talked to the owner. She said, "I'm the owner, I want an offer." Then he asked her about the condition. So after talking with her, he put cosmetic rehab. So that means it's maybe outdated, that needs updating. Maybe it's in really good shape, it just needs updated kitchens, updated bathrooms, updated property. Maybe everything's old, right? And then Andre did go in and put in comps that he found, put his wholesale fee in here, and he just wants us to double check the offer. So we're gonna go in and go into Redfin. So we use Redfin for comping properties. So we just take the address here, and we're gonna go into Redfin.com. It's a free website. It's like same thing. MLS data that agents can use. So here we have the property. So it's a frame. This was sold back in 2012. So these pictures here are probably from like 10, 11 years ago. So it's probably not in the same condition. He said cosmetic. So these pictures look like it's a total gut rehab, right? So the current owner probably rehabbed this property already. So what we do to get the comps that are, we're just checking if the comps are accurate that were entered. You go to this map here, and then the left corner is new search. And then we have all the active comps that are with a few blocks away from the house. So what we're trying to do is look for sold. We go to sold. We do the same thing an appraiser would do, sold in the last 6 months. Same type of house as a single family home, so we're gonna go single family, and the square footage on this is 1,062. So this, we're gonna go, you go about 10% plus than everything below that. So if you use a calculator here, 1,062, 10% is 106, so plus 162 is 1,168. So we'll probably be under 1,200 and under for the comps. So we only have one comp here. So I also changed it from high to low. So what we're gonna do in this situation is we're gonna zoom out. If I had like 10 good comps here, I wouldn't zoom out. I would just use the comps that you have, but there's no comps here, so I gotta zoom out once and see what we get. So there's only two comps. So this is about a half a mile, and again, I like to see close to 10 properties at least. So I'm gonna zoom out one more time to get about a mile radius from the property. And you can see there's only three comps. So I don't have a lot of sold comparables to work with, but you, The only thing you can do in this situation is to work with the comps that you have, right? So this is 1,062 square feet. I'm just making sure. I wonder how he got those comps. So 4409. So he got 152, 150. I don't see that at all. So maybe he went back a year. So sometimes you got to go back a year. Like, I don't have enough comps. I only had two comps there. So sometimes you have to, instead of 6 months, you go back 1 year. And a professional appraiser that appraises houses for their value also does that. If he doesn't have enough comps, he'll actually go back a year to look at properties. So you see that? Now we have seven. So this is good amount. So like I said, try to get close to 10. So you can see that this property at 255 is fully rehabbed, great shape. This property at 205, sometimes you gotta click on it to see the front of it. But this one's, all these properties are comparable. They're single families, they're same size as the property. They are sold within a mile of the house. They're sold in the last 12 months, in the last year. So I can use these three here. They're all single family, they're all the same size. And you can see pictures of this one. You can see it's fully rehabbed, great condition. So we're going to use these top three comps. So you're trying to get the we're trying to get the after rehab value. So once this property is fully rehabbed, nice kitchens, nice bathrooms, everything's updated, what is the value of the home, right? So that's what we're doing here. So we're gonna, these are the three comps I'm gonna use: 255, 205, and 150. So I simply go on the CRM and I enter that. So his comps were pretty off. 255, 205, and then 150. And then another thing you want to look at, what you could do, of course you want to ask the owner, but when you're in Redfin or in Deal Machine, if you go to property details, it tells you if there's a basement. So like I said before, like in the CRM, you have to enter the square footage of the basement if comps have finished basements, but this one doesn't have a basement, right? And it looks like these properties, if we click on them, if you just simply go to property details, you can see right here, there's no basements, like a crawl space. But you're in Florida, Ronnie, so you don't got to worry about that. Basements are more so of like a central,
Right.
like Chicago thing, Indiana thing, yeah. So these comps don't have basements, I'm sure. So we're gonna leave that the basement, those square footage blank. But if there is a basement needs to be finished, you would add that, and then that's gonna add to the rehab costs. So that's gonna lower the offer a lot. So if you miss that, you could really get the offer off by a lot. But so we have the three comps in here. We have the wholesale fee, market rent. That's the next thing is let's make sure that's correct. So we'll go to Zillow. You can just Google Zillow rental calculator, and just maybe save this page that so that you can bookmark it. And you just put the address in, and then you'll see the market rent is $1,375, so that's right. You can see here, I have the after rehab value. This property after it's fixed up and rehab is worth 203. The rehab costs, if it's truly a cosmetic rehab, I don't have pictures, I'm just going by what our student told us. It's only 21,000. So a cosmetic rehab means like it's in great shape, all it needs is updating, right? So that's a small rehab budget. So you can see here, I calculated the rehab cost or the AR, the after rehab value, and I got my maximum cash offer. So it quickly calculated it. So if you want, like, If you get really good at this, like you're really quick about getting the offers in the CRM, you can be on the same phone call with the owner and say, "Hey, can I put you on hold for, three, 4, 5 minutes? Can I put you on hold for 5 minutes, and I'll come up with the offer for you." And you can get him back on the phone and say, "Hey, Mr. Seller, so I came up with the numbers, and the max the cash offer, we're getting is 95,000. Of course, you want to start lower than this because this is your maximum offer, right?" And one more thing before you make that offer is that you want to double check the area. So double checking always means looking at everything active on the market. So I change it from sold to active on Redfin. So I go back to Redfin, and then I'm looking at all the lowest active properties available. And I'm also going to take off the square footage, because if I see a property that is bigger selling cheaper, I want to see it. I want to see that. So you see the if I'm an investor in this area, if I'm an investor and I like to always be like a mile out. You can, sometimes you're zoomed in too much. You just go further back, but you can see the cheapest deal in this area. If I'm an investor and I want to go and invest in Valparaiso, Indiana, this area, the cheapest deal I can buy right now is 174, right? So keep that in mind. 174 is the cheapest, and it's in great shape too. This is really good shape. And this one's in bad shape, 174. I'm not sure why that one and one, this one is selling good shape. It's probably on a like a bad area, or like on a, but yeah, it's on a busy, the main street, so that's probably why. So this one, 174, is a gut re like a total rehab, looks like. So just keep that in mind, the 174, right? So I can actually come up on this offer. So this is when you know you can come up on your offer. So the highest I'll go up is 75%. I wouldn't go higher than that, because investors that are fix and flipping, typically they're hard money lenders or private money lenders. They lend at this formula. They take the after rehab value, 75% at most, minus rehab costs. So I can go up on this. So now I can go up on my offer. So you saw that? Now I'm up to 121, right? Because of what I see active. Now, if the opposite happened, where I check all the actives and there's properties selling for 100,000, and I'm about to make an offer for 110 and try to sell for 120, but I see a bunch of properties active that are the same size, same type of property that are nearby, I need to lower my offer, right? So in that situation, I may need to change my percentage, where instead of 75%, it's 60%. And you see that now the offer is 90,000. So if I see active comp, an investor can just go buy one down the street for 100,000, I need to be lower than that, right? So I need to be selling lower. So let's say all the lowest active comps are selling for 100. I can offer him 90 and then try to sell it just below everybody at like 99, right? So I'm still the best deal on the market, just a smidge below everybody else. Does that make sense?
Right, yes.
Yeah. You have any questions?
No, I'm good. I'm good.
Yeah, pretty straightforward. Okay. So that's how we come up with this offer here. So again, Andre is one of our students. He actually closed like six deals with us in the less than a year. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna save this. Wait, I didn't. It's a 75%, not 60. So the 121 is the highest. So I'm gonna save this. I'm going to now go to email. And I'm going to go to email template here, this arrow, to come up with the script for the offers. So I go to again the arrow, and then I go to for the offers for offer letter of intent. And here is the script that I'm going to send. So I copy this, and I'm going to send it to Andre. And now he has it. So I'm not sure if it's livable or not. So if the property is in livable condition, rentable as is, some cosmetic rehabs are could be lived in, could be rented out. If that's the case, we can make the sandwich rent to own offer, the lease option assignment or rent to own assignment offer. We can make the Airbnb offer. So I'm gonna send them all the offers. So boom, it's done. So if you're out there, on Deal Machine calling leads, or once you get someone raise their hand, this is the process. You just simply are gonna go fill out all the information in the CRM. You'll send us an email and say, hey, this you just have to make sure that you talk to the owner. The owner wants an offer, and they told you about the condition of the property, and you selected the right option. If you've done that, you can just send us an email, say, hey, Russell, here's the deal. Can you come up with the offers for me? Help me out. And then we will email you back the offers that we came up with to make sure you're making the right offers. Okay. So very simple process.
Right.
And of course, we eventually want you to be able to not wait on us, that you eventually make offers on your own, right? Like, you don't have to wait on us, because you're pretty eventually you're going to get really good at making offers on your own. Once you've done 20, 30, 100 offers, you can do it on your own. You don't need us to analyze it for you, right? But yeah, in the beginning, we can handhold you. We can come up with the offer for you, so that you don't have to be afraid that you're making the wrong offer, right? So let's go over another one. Just to get a little bit more practice. So does that make sense? Like, just come up with the offers is pretty simple.
Yeah, it's really, really nice.
Okay.
Makes sense.
So this lead is not in the CRM. Okay. You can also send the link. You can also send the link of the lead. And what that means is, when you're in the lead, you just go to the address bar and you just copy it. So for example, let's say this lead here is the one I want our team to look at. I can just go here, copy it, and I can just send the email. So you send the email to Best Chicago Wholesale Deals at Gmail, and then you can send the link. You can put the, if you want to put the ad, you can put the address. We prefer the address in the subject line. And then, you can also put the seller's name. If you want us to know some information about it, you can type out information that we need to know. But you should also put that in the notes, like, of the lead, like any information of the property. You can actually put that here in the notes area, like any information we need to know. And then you just send it. So once you send that, our team gets it, and in 24 hours, as long as it's not Sunday, we will be sending you the offer to make. Okay. So that lead's not in there. So let's work. So this is one of our partners that got a contract signed. So we got a new deal signed, 1630 Aberdeen. So let's go over this deal. So we're probably going to market this one tomorrow to our buyers list. So you can see the contract on this one is for to purchase is for 90,000. Oh, she did tell me that she got the price reduced to 80, but we can take a look at this one. So this is a potential deal where we can make 10, maybe 20,000 in profit on a wholesale. So we're gonna just analyze this and show you how we came up with the offers and everything. Okay. So here's the deal that we just got under contract with our team. And we got it under contract at the contract says 90, but she just did tell me she got a reduction to 80, so I'm gonna ask her about that. So let's take a look at this deal. So this is a this is not the actual condition, because they did some work to it. I saw some pictures. So here's a street view. So look at that. So it's like new siding. The roof looks like it needs to be new. It needs a new roof. It looks like they maybe put in windows, siding. The garage looks new. So the outside looks like it's almost finished. It's probably finished already. They just, you know, it's Google Maps is like six, like a few months old, right? So the outside is in good shape. The inside is gutted. They took everything out, so it's just like a shell, but it needs everything. So we're gonna estimate this in the in Redfin, and then we're also going to, I don't think she put this in the CRM. So we're gonna create a lead and just go over this. So let's just say this is a brand new lead. The owner raises their hand, says they want an offer. This is my partner's name. So I'm just gonna put her information in here. I'm just gonna go over how we came up with the offer, okay? So 1630 Aberdeen, Chicago Heights. We put the address in here. And I'm just gonna very quickly just focus on the square footage condition, comps, and just the things that come up with the offers. And this property is 2,000 square feet, and it does have a basement. So it's 2,000 square feet. And I don't believe the basement needs to be finished. I'm gonna check because we're gonna look at the comps to see if the basement needs to be finished. Rehab required. I would say it's a gut rehab. The outside is almost done. This just needs a roof, but everything else looks like window siding are done. So I'm gonna say just the inside, the gut rehab. The garage looks good, the landscaping, the outside looks, except for the roof. And then now we're gonna get the comps. So that's it. So square footage, condition, and then the next thing is the comps. And Ronnie, if you have any questions, while I'm doing any of this, just, you know, interrupt me and let me know, okay?
Sure.
So again, we go to the map. We go to, I'm just gonna go back. The little map here, go to new search. And we're gonna do the same thing an appraiser would do, sold in the last 6 months. And this is a single family home. And this has 2,000 square feet. So we're probably gonna be at around 2,200 and under, 10% plus. So we'll go 2,250 and under. And then we're going to price it from high to low. So there's eight properties here, and it looks like our house is a lot bigger than all of them. So I am going to zoom out to see if I see a property that is if I see a property that is similar size. So here's 165. And what you could do as well is when you're comping properties, I don't like to cross like the main highways, like the main streets. You see that when you're on Redfin. So the yellow lines are like highways, like the main streets. And usually, like if you're crossing main intersections, property values change, you know, dramatically, right? So here we got 224, 205, 177, 224, 205. And all these properties are smaller. So you see this is only 1568, 1636, 1200 square feet. So these are all a lot smaller. So in that situation, I don't need to, like, you don't need to worry about basements in your area, but here we do. I would leave basement square footage as zero because our property is a lot bigger than all the comps already. and I put gut rehab, and you're gonna see $10,000. So I put your wholesale fee in here, what you want. And there's a total rehab on the inside of, so once I put the comps, I got the maximum cash offer at 81,000. That's using the 75%. So again, let's double check all the actives and see what's going on. And this is a bigger house, so you're looking at, can an investor go in this area and buy a house that is similar, cheaper than me, right? Like, this is only 800 square feet, so this is not really similar at 65, 69, 135. This is 1700, so this is not too far off. So if I zoom out, I'm gonna zoom out to get like a mile radius, and let's see if I see anything. So this is 81, but it's only 700 square feet. It's a tiny house. This one at 69. You go down to like the property, this is only 1,000 square feet. So this is our property is double the size of this. Let's see, 114, 990. So yeah, I don't see anything. Like, only this one, 135. It's 1,700 square feet. So it's close to our square footage, but it's 135. So I could go up to that 75% because the cheapest one active is 135, and my offer is 81 with a $10,000 wholesale fee. So our plan is to, try to sell this for 91 on the to investors. So, like I said, she did tell me she got the contract down to 80. So I'm gonna message her. See, hey, did you get updated agreement? 80,000 purchase price. Because yeah, we need to get that. If we're gonna sell it off market to an investor, we need to get that down to 80. And then try to sell it for 90, so it'll make 10 grand. We can try to push it and try to sell for a little bit more, like 95, to try to create a bigger spread. But yeah, so this one, I save it. And again, I'm gonna go to email, this email template arrow here, core offer letter of intent, and then I simply so this one's like I said, it's not livable. You can't rent it out as is. It needs a total rehab on the interior. So this one we can only make the cash offer, and the other offer would be to do the straight option, the option listing offer. So I'm not doing the Airbnb offer. So you only have these two because it needs everything on the inside. It's not livable. So also you can get rid of this on the bottom because this is all about rent to own, lease options, Airbnb. So I can get rid of all that, and then these are my only two options I have for them, right? So if I'm going to negotiation with the seller, I'm like, this is my max offer. I would probably start at like 70, and then try to lock it in at 80 at the most. And then if they don't accept that offer, I can turn around and say, hey, Mr. Seller, I understand the offer doesn't work for you. Another option we have is that we can utilize our network of investors that we have and realtors that we work with. And you can net your, let's say she's stuck at, 100,000. You can net your 100,000. And then we'll add our, we simply just add our fee on top of that, utilizing our realtors and our network of investors. And then we do put the deal on the market on the MLS, but our goal is to get it closed and sold for you as quickly as possible. So that's kind of the transition to the straight option offer. And this we list it. So we would send it to a realtor. He would list it. He'll add our fee on top, and then we'll try to still sell it even if the cash offer doesn't work. But You want to do everything you can if you can to get the cash offer, because in the cash offer we can get paid in a couple weeks, and whereas this offer is a lot higher, so we're looking for more of a retail buyer, maybe someone that's going to get a loan, and it may take months to get paid. Sometimes these deals don't sell at all because they're priced too high. So this is the la last option, right? Okay, so that's how we came up with those two offers. So what do you think? Do you think you're ready to analyze deals and come up with offers?
I can tell you know, not completely, but you know, my sense is easy, but I have to practice. I have to practice and put it all together.
Yeah. So
And
you
I have
saw
a question. And I have a question. We can make an offer to manufacture home.
Yeah, but when you're getting the comps, you're looking at only you're not looking at single family home, you'd be looking at a manufactured home. So what that means is when you're in the Redfin and you're getting comps, you would go to mobile home right here
Right.
instead of house. Because mobile home is it's like selling a car, so that it doesn't have the va same value as a house.
Right.
Yeah, so you can do that as long as you get comps that are same, like that are mobile homes too.
Right.
So how you feeling, man? You ready to just get out there and make calls and make offers?
Yes.
Yeah.
I'm ready. I'm doing.
Awesome.
I started. I started contacting some leads, and you know, getting calls, and you know,
Awesome. So
waiting for
you already took
expecting
action
phone
and
calls.
started calling people?
Yeah.
Awesome, man. That's the first step is, you know, getting over that fear of talking to people. So that's good that you already started. So and
Thank you. Thank you.
that's why we're doing this getting started series is just to give you confidence that, hey, after I watch all these, you know, go through all this training with Russell, I'm just ready to go out there and just know that, like, you know, all you gotta do is get someone to say yes, I want an offer, and then we'll help you analyze it. You know, we'll help you get it sold. We'll help you know,
Thank you. Thank you.
help you get the funding for the property to close on it. So you have everything in the back end. You know, once we have a contract signed, we can take it from there, and then we're the ones that are, you know, we'll sell it. We'll, you know, whatever strategy, exit strategy we have, we'll. Our goal is to help you profit it. So,
All right. Sure. Thank you, brother.
all right, brother.
Yes, I'm gonna be calling people, texting, contact leads.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, let me know if you need any help. Just reach out. And
Thank you. As soon as somebody raise your hand, as soon as somebody raise their hand, I'm gonna call you and I'm gonna tell you, hey, I got some people that raise their hands. So let's
yeah,
do an offer.
exactly. So just shoot an email over with the lead, and then we take it from there, send you the offer to make. You call the seller back, make the offers, and if they accept, you know, at that point we'll walk you through. We'll send you the contract to fill out. We can fill it out. We can fill it out for you and send it to you. So, you know, we're here to handhold you, help you through the whole process. Okay.
Thank you, brother. I really appreciate that.
All right, brother. You got to get back to work, so I'll let you get back, man.
All right, so you stop recording?
Let me hit stop.